So people say that the best camera is gonna be the one that you always have with you, and that is especially true if you are a user of the iPhone 11 Pro, 11 Pro Max, even the iPhone 11, because this takes some outstanding photo and videos. Now, I recently had the opportunity to go ahead and travel to Switzerland and walk across the highest suspension bridge in all of Europe. Spoiler alert, it was amazing. But I think it would be a great opportunity to showcase the DoubleTake app, which allows you to go ahead and capture multiple video streams from your iPhone and really use it kind of as an effective way to go ahead and tell stories. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you what it is, how it works, and when you'd want to use it. Let's get started. Now, you might not know anything about Switzerland, but Mount Titlis is located in central Switzerland, real close to Lucerne. And it is home of the highest suspension bridge in all of Europe. It's 10,600 and maybe 23 feet above sea level. And the suspension bridge is 320 feet across, 150 steps, and it's nothing short of exhilarating, exciting, breathtaking, and scary to walk across it because it's all open air. You're so high in the air and it's windy, right? Like you feel the bridge kind of swaying from side to side. It's definitely worth it. So I would say if you have the opportunity, I would consider going. Now, the app I've been talking about is called DoubleTake, and it is a free app from the same folks that bring you Filmic Pro. And if you don't know about Filmic Pro is probably the most robust, I would say, camera app for the iPhone because you can almost set up and configure any number of settings to really dial in the type of video and the quality of the video that you want on the iPhone. And I'd say it's probably the premier video app that that people who shoot on the iPhone exclusively tend to use. Now, when it captures multiple streams of video, those two video streams are capped at 1080p, and they're gonna be either recorded at 24, 25, or 30 frames per second. Now, everyone knows 24 frames per second is really the only way to record a video, unless you're gonna go ahead and slow something down in post, and maybe you'll record it at 30, but I digress, 24 frames for life. Now, that resolution, like I said, is capped at 1080, and that's not really the developer being lazy and not wanting to give you 4K, but that is a limitation of Apple's APIs. But, you know, looking at the reviews, not that they're bad, but some people complaining about the resolution being limited to 1080, and that's not necessarily something that the developer can go ahead and manage too. It's only something that they can work with because that's all the API from Apple supports. Hopefully in iOS 14, Apple will go ahead and increase the resolution, giving you some 4K, maybe, who knows, maybe 8K, whatever the case is, but better resolution in that next version of iOS. All right, now that we talked about what DoubleTake is, let's go ahead and set up our phone to record some video. All right, opening the app, we are presented with really what the viewfinder is, and there are four different glyphs on each of the four corners. So top left-hand corner is gonna be the save icon, bottom left-hand corner is gonna go ahead and select cameras, top right-hand corner is gonna go ahead and also go ahead and choose a recording mode, and the bottom right-hand corner is gonna be the record button. Let's go ahead and start with the camera selection. So now we're presented with all four cameras. Now for me, it's gonna be all four cameras because I have an iPhone 11 Pro Max, and we see each of the four cameras listed, ultra wide, wide, tele, and self camera. Now, whatever camera you choose as the A camera is gonna be your primary camera. Now for me, let's go ahead and choose the ultra wide, and we're gonna choose the selfie camera. So that's gonna show A and B. Let's go ahead and click confirm. And now we have what's gonna be in the primary window, which is the ultra wide, and what's gonna be here in the, what's gonna be in the picture-in-picture camera is gonna be the selfie camera. Now, if we click in the top right corner and go to the recording mode, clicking it once brings us into picture-in-picture mode. And what that means is that everything that we record is gonna be shown and in the video file. And this is gonna be an integrated video file. If we do the split screen, it's gonna show 50-50 split. Again, this is gonna be an integrated video file. Now, if we go ahead and hit record, now here's gonna be, this is gonna be two different video files, and we can go ahead and move this selfie camera all the way around on the screen just by dragging and dropping it. We can move it around the screen, we can bring it back out. All right, now again, this is gonna record as two separate video files, so it doesn't really matter where you put it on the screen. You can go to the main camera, let's go ahead and tap here in the center. Now it's gonna allow me to focus on me, which is great. Hey, how you doing? If we go back here, and we can then individually focus on another part of the screen. If we want to lock it, we're just going to hold down the focus button until it is a solid rectangle. Now we see here, and these two focuses are being controlled independently. Now if we hit stop, let's go to the file menu, and we see here camera A, camera B are recorded as two separate video files. Now if we go here and change this back, let's go and change it from the individual to picture in picture. Let's snap record, and really this, it's the same experience except for the recording file is gonna show everything that we do and move along with this video file. So if I hit stop here, I go to the files. Now, instead of saving two files like we would have expected it did, it actually shows one file that is, and there you see that B camera moving all the way around from different places inside the video file. Now, split screen is really the same thing, so it's gonna give you a 50-50 even split of the front-facing camera, camera A, and then camera B here on the side. This is gonna be an integrated video file. You can't change that. I don't like particularly recording that way. I like doing the discrete files where I'm having an individual file for each camera. It allows me to go ahead and mess with it in post, and that's actually what I did when I was in Switzerland crossing the bridge. So I had two different video files, and I was able to manipulate the B camera, which is my selfie camera, any which way I wanted to go ahead and come up with a certain look. Otherwise, I would have been stuck with having that picture-in-picture view during the video file. Now, in terms of pros, I would say, you know, you can record two simultaneous video streams. Those video streams can be either recorded into a single file or into a simultaneous file. Third thing is that it is gonna go ahead and allow you to lock the focus and exposure controls independently per frame, in addition to allowing that to be independent of one another. The downside is that, you know, the app doesn't allow you to go ahead and snap frames, you know, allow and take individual pictures while you're recording, one. Two, it doesn't allow you to go ahead and record anything higher than 1080p. You know, hey, listen, it's just a limitation of the app. And three, it doesn't appear to leverage the individual mics that are on the back of the phone. So I know each time that I recorded the back camera and the front-facing camera, it did seem to use only one of the mics. You could just tell the difference in the audio quality. But let me know if your experiences are different in the comments below. Now, that is going to wrap it up for me, folks. Let me know how you plan to use the DoubleTake app to go ahead and become a better storyteller in the comments below. I am Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one.